matrix is to be invertible, determinant of A should be equal to not equal to 0. It should be non-singular. So 1, 2, 3, 0, 2, 4, 0, 0, 5. So we can open it from two zeros are there in the first column itself. Open it from first column, that is 1 plus 1 into 10 minus 0. So 10. So this is not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. What is the next step of finding the inverse? Okay, so first you have to find the cofactor matrix. See, I am simplifying the cofactor matrix. Cofactor matrix. You can follow this. First, this one is a plus. Then remove first row and the first column. You will get 10 minus 0. The second element is cofactor is negative sign minus. So remove the second column and the first row. You will get 0. Then the third cofactor element is that is A13, that is A13, plus sign is there. Then remove this first row and the third column, 0 minus 0. So you can do it like this. So next A21, so here you remove this and this, you will get a 10 minus 0. The sign is minus 10 minus 0. Then the sign is plus. You take out this second row and second column. Then 1 into 5 is 5. Then 0 into 3 is 0. Then the other element, the sign is A, 2, 3. So it is negative sign. The negative sign, you take this 1 into 0 minus 0. Next, this element A31 is positive, that is 8 minus 6. So we have done in many problems. Now you should understand this. So here 4 minus 0, and then last one, last element A33 element, positive sign. Next, last element is 2 minus 0.
Hello. So this is 8 minus 6 minus 4 minus 0 plus this is 2 minus 0. Now we have got the cofactor matrix. We will write it. That is first element is 10, the other elements are 0, 0, 0. Here minus 10. Plus 5 and again 0. Here 8 minus 6 minus 4, that is 2. This is 2 minus 4 and then plus 2. Now let us take this. This is adj A. What is adj A? Transpose of the cofactor matrix. adj A. adj A we can write. 10, 0, 0, minus 10, 5, 0, 2, minus 4, 2. Then we have to take the inverse. Inverse is A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of A into adj A. 1 by determinant of A into adj A is the inverse for that. Now I will write the A inverse 1 by determinant of A into adj A. Here determinant of A is 10. So adjoint of the matrix is 10 minus 10, 2, 0, 5 minus 4, 0, 0, 2. So this is the answer for this question inverse. So in the next exercise we will be doing solutions of linear system of equations. There inverse is the important thing. So from the inverse only we are going to find out the values of the x, y, z in the linear system of equations. Now let us go to another one question, that is 8. Let us take A is equal to 100 330 and 5 2 -1. First of all, we have to verify whether the matrix is singular or non-singular. Only non-singular matrix we can have inverse. Now, determinant of A is determinant 100 330 52 -1. So, expanding through first row, because two zeros are there, 1 into, you see -3 -0, which is equal to -3, not equal to 0. A inverse exists. The next step is cofactor matrix. Cofactor matrix. So, how to do the cofactor matrix? I have already told, first plus sign -3 -0, then minus sign you take, -3 -0, then again plus sign. So, 6 - 15. So, this is our cofactor matrix. Next element is -0 -0, then again plus sign -1 -0, then again we have to take minus sign. So that is 2, and this 2 - 0, then again plus sign here. For plus sign, that is remove this 0 - 0, then again minus sign. For minus sign, you see 1 into 0 3 into 0, that is 0 0. The last element is this is 3 - 0. So what is the cofactor matrix? Let us write. First element is -3, then 3 - 9 0 - 1 - 2 0 0 and +3. This is the cofactor matrix. Again, next step is the answer, that is A inverse or adj A. We have to do it adj A. Adj A is transpose, that is the first row becomes first column, second row becomes second column, third row becomes third column. So, this is adjoint of the matrix. Then A inverse is equal to 1 - -3 × adjoint of the matrix is -3 0 0 3 - 1 0 - 9 - 2 3. So, this is the adjoint of the matrix. So, A inverse is equal to 1 determinant of A × adj A. So, I will not be doing all the problems in the this one. This is the same method we have to proceed. We will see different type of questions. So, I will do one or two problems again with the inverse, and then we will change to other question. Another question where we have to find inverse of the given matrix. Now, let us do first determinant of this matrix, prove that it is non-singular, then only we can find the inverse. -7 2 comma 1 Now this is 2 into minus 1 minus 0, then minus 1 into 4 minus 0 plus 3 into 8, this is plus 7, 8 minus 7. So this is minus 2, minus 4, and then plus 3. So not equal to 0, minus 3 is the determinant value. So A inverse exists. Now next step is as usual cofactor matrix, then adjoint of the matrix, and A inverse, which is 1 by determinant of A into adj A. So these are the steps. So let us do only one more problem in this inverse. We will go to the next model problems. Okay. Now cofactor matrix I am going to do. Cofactor matrix for this A. Cofactor matrix. So one advantage of this is here itself it is there already. The same thing will follow for, but this 2 will not be there for cofactor, and here 4 minus 0, then here plus 8 minus 7. Then let us go to the second one, second row and the first column remove it, 1 minus 6 plus, remove this, 2 minus 10, this becomes a plus 10, so minus 4 plus 7, then again plus sign, okay. So first row and third column, third row and first column you remove it, 0 plus 3 minus, so here 0 minus 12. Plus minus 2 minus 4. So the cofactor matrix is this. First element is minus 1, second element is minus 4, and then 1. Here we get 5. 1 minus 6 minus 5, minus half minus 5, the 12. We get 12 here, minus 11, and 3, 12. And minus 6. Now from this we can write adj A. Adj A is minus 1, minus 4, 1, 5, 12, minus 11, and then 3, 12, minus 6. Minus 1, minus 4, minus 1, 5, 12. So this one problem, one element is this element is this one. So this is A 2, 2. So second row, second column, so you see here 2, but 7 minus 3 is 21. So this will be 23. Now this element is 23, 5, 23 minus 11, okay. Now A inverse is equal to, you can write 1 by determinant of A, that is minus 3, and then adj A, 1, 5, 3, minus 4, 23, 12, 1, minus 11, minus 6, okay, it is over. Now, I will write the problem number 10, A is equal to 1, minus 1, 2, 0, 2 minus 3, 3 minus 2, 4. So do it. it yourself. Do it yourself. Three problems I have already done. And now the 11th problem let me take. A is equal to 100 cos alpha sin alpha 0 sin alpha minus cos alpha. First, we have to find out determinant of A. Determinant of A is 100 cos alpha sin alpha and 0 sin alpha minus cos alpha. So, if you expand it through R column 1, we get 1 into, you see, minus cos square alpha minus sin square alpha minus cos square alpha minus, if you take out cos square alpha plus sin square alpha, it is minus 1. So, minus 1 not equal to 0. Therefore, A inverse exists. Now, cofactor matrix. Cofactor matrix, let us do first plus sign. Minus cos square alpha minus sin square alpha, then minus sign. This is first row and the second column, remove it, 0 minus 0, then plus sign. So, first row and the third column, remove it, 0 minus 0. So, this is our cofactor matrix we are doing. Then you take the minus sign for this element, minus sign. So, A 2 1 second row and first column, remove it. So, this is 0 into minus cos alpha is 0 and 0 into sin alpha is also 0, 0 minus 0, then plus sign, the middle element, that is take out this second row, second column, minus cos alpha minus 0 minus. So, you have to remove second row and third column, that is sin alpha minus 0, sin alpha minus 0. Then we have to take plus sign, if you take it, 0 minus 0 we get. Minus sign let us take, and then that is the third row and the second column, remove it. So, sin alpha minus 0, sin alpha minus 0, then again plus sign, cos alpha minus 0, cos alpha minus 0. Now, we will write the cofactor matrix. Cofactor matrix is equal to minus 1, 0, 0, here again 0, minus cos alpha, minus sin alpha, again here you take 0 and then minus sin alpha and then cos alpha. Now, what is the adjoint? Adjoint is transpose of the cofactor matrix. This is cofactor matrix. This is cofactor matrix. Transpose of the cofactor matrix, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, minus cos alpha, minus sin alpha, then 0, minus sin alpha, cos alpha. This is the adjoint. What is the inverse? A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of A. Determinant of A is minus 1, we have calculated. Now, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, minus cos alpha, minus sin alpha, 0, minus sin alpha cos alpha. Now you take this determinant, if you take minus sign inside, you have to multiply all the terms inside the matrix by minus sign, that is 0 cos alpha sin alpha, 0 sin alpha minus cos alpha. So this is the inverse, this is the A inverse, 100, 0 cos alpha sin alpha, 0 sin alpha minus cos alpha. You see, A, that is also equal to A itself. The matrix itself is the inverse of the matrix, this particular thing. So you should remember this for entrance examinations, we should remember this. So 100, 0 cos alpha sin alpha, 0 sin alpha minus cos alpha. Let A is equal to matrix 3, 7, 2, 5. B is equal to 6, 8, 7, 9. Verify AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse. That means this is called reversal law of inverses. Already I have done a problem on this model. Now we will do this also, which is in the exercise. First, what we have to do, we have to make sure that A inverse, B inverse, AB whole inverse exists. Now let me do this determinant of A. Determinant of A is, see whether it exists, we will verify. 3 into 5, 15 minus 14, which is equal to 1. So is not equal to 0. A inverse exists. A inverse exists. Now let us take B. Determinant of B is 6, 8, 7, 9. Multiply this. 9 sixes are 54 minus 56. It is minus 2, not equal to 0. Therefore, B inverse also exists. Now let us calculate AB, product of A and B, that is 3, 7, 2, 5, 7, 6, 8, 7, 9. Okay. Now how will you multiply this first row with the first column, that is 3 into 6, 18, 18 plus 49, what is that? 67. Then 3 into 8, 24. 24 plus 7 into 9, 63, 24 plus 63, that is 63 plus 24, which is 87, 2 into 6, 12, this is 35, 12 plus 35, 47, this is 47. And then let us take this 16 minus 45, first 16 plus 45, 16 plus 45 is 61. Now we have to take the determinant of AB. Determinant of AB is 67, 87, 47, 61. So multiply this 67 into 61 minus 87 into 67. So on multiplying this, 67 into 61. You can see what is the values, that is 4087, 87 into 67, So let us check whether any error is there. Let us see, 3 into 6, 18, 47, 49 plus 18, 67, 24 plus 63, 87, 12 plus 35, 47. Let us see here, any 7 in, 7 ones are 7, 6, 42, 6, 6, 40, this is 4087. Let us verify this, 7 sevens are 49. 56, 0, 7, 6 are 42, then 52, 5829 we are getting. Let me verify this. Okay, this is 87 into this is 47. Okay, 87 into 47. Let us verify this. 7 fours are 28. 8 fours are 32. 34 we get. So this is 89 4 0 8 9. So this becomes minus 2, not equal to 0. Therefore, AB inverse exists. AB inverse exists. Now let us find AB whole inverse. How to find AB whole inverse? AB whole inverse is 1 by determinant of AB into adjoint of AB. How to find the adjoint of AB for this? So interchange these elements 61 and 67, change the sign of minus 87 and 47. So this is the inverse. Okay, let us keep this as equation 1. Now let us take B inverse like that, same thing, 1 by minus 2. How to find B inverse? This is B. So interchange the principal diagonal elements and adjoint I am doing now, adjoint. So this is the inverse of B. Then inverse of A, let us do 1 divided by 1 into 5 3 minus 7 minus 2. Now let us calculate B inverse A inverse. 1 by minus 2 into 9 minus 8 minus 7 6, 5 minus 7 minus 2 3. Now let us multiply this. 9 5s are 45 plus 16, 45 plus 16 is 61. Then 9 into minus 7, minus 63, minus 24. So minus 87, minus 87. 7 minus 7 into 5 is minus 35, minus 12. So it is minus 47. Then minus 7 into minus 7, 49, 6 into 3, 18. 49 plus 18, we get 67. Let us keep this as 2. From 1 and 2, we can prove that AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse. Both are same, you see. 1 by minus 2 into 61 minus 87 minus 47 minus 67. So that is the answer for this question. Now let us go to the next question now. This is another model. If A is equal to 3 1 minus 1 2, A is equal to 3 1 minus 1 2, show that A square minus 5A plus 7I is equal to 0. Hence find A inverse, using that we have to find A inverse, where I is the identity matrix, second order identity matrix. Now first here we have to calculate A square. A square is 3 1 matrix 3 1 minus 1 2 multiplied by 3 1 minus 1 2. So multiplying this matrix, you see 9 minus 1, which is 8. 3 into 1, 1 into 2. That is 3 into 1, 3 plus 2, 5. Minus 3 minus 2, we get here minus 5. So minus 1 plus 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. So this is a square. What is minus 5a? So, or 5a, I will write it here. What is 5a? 15, 5, minus 5, 10. That is 5a. Now, let us prove that a square minus 5a plus 7i is equal to a null matrix, O matrix. This is, you don't try read it as O, 0, but it is O. Okay. Now, a square minus 5a plus 7i is equal to a square. I will write a square. A square is 8, 5, minus 5, 3. So, minus 5a, that is 15, 5, minus 5, 10. 7i, what is the identity matrix? 1, 0, 0, 1. So, 7 if you multiply, 7, 0, 0, 7. Now, simplify this. You can simplify directly. See, 8 plus 7, 15 minus 15, 0. 5 minus 5 plus 0, that is also 0. Minus 5 plus 5 plus 0, so this is also 0. 3 plus 7, 10 minus 10, so 0. So, this is O matrix. So, we have proved it. From this, we have to find A inverse. How we have to do it? Let us see this. A square minus 5a plus 7i is equal to O matrix. Multiply this matrix, multiply this equation, multiply by or pre-multiply by A inverse. See, post-multiply means afterwards, pre-multiply means before. Okay. A inverse A into A minus 5 into A inverse A plus 7 into A inverse into I. So, A inverse with null matrix is 0 matrix only. Now, this by associative property of matrix multiplication, we can write that as A inverse A into A minus A inverse I. A inverse A is identity matrix. And we get here A inverse into I is A inverse. Do you understand? There are three steps here. A inverse multiplied by A, associative property. Here A inverse A, inverse property, that is I we get. And then A inverse I, which is A inverse. Now, this becomes I minus A minus 5i plus 7 A inverse is equal to 0. Now, this is A minus I into A is A matrix only. 5i plus 7 A inverse is equal to O matrix. Now, we can easily calculate 7 A inverse is equal to 5i minus A. Now, what is 5i? 5005 minus what is A matrix? A matrix is given here, 3, 1, minus 1, 2, 3, 1, minus 1, 2. So, now 7 A inverse is equal to 5 minus 3, 2, 0 minus 1, minus 1. Now, 0 minus of minus 1 plus 1, 5 minus 2, 3. So, A inverse is equal to 1 by 7 into 2 minus 1 1, 3. So this is the inverse of the matrix. This is the method of finding inverse using that given equation. Let us verify this. See, whenever we have second order matrix, interchange 2, 1, 3. 2, 1, 3 is interchange. Change the sign of 1 and minus 1. So this is the correct result. Now let us go to the next model question. Okay. For matrix A, which is equal to 3, 2, 1, 1, find the numbers A and B such that A square plus small a into capital A, that is the matrix, and then B into identity matrix I. Now for this, we have to take A square 3, 2, 1, 1 multiplied with 3, 2, 1, 1, A square matrix we are doing, multiply A by A. Now 3 into 3, 9 plus 2, 3 into 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 1 into 3, 3, 1 into 1, 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 1 into 2, 2, 1 into 1. So this is our A square matrix. Now let us get the equation A square minus small a into bi is equal to O matrix. So the here 11, 8, 4, 3 minus, let us take the A matrix here, that is 3 multiplied by A, 2A, A, plus B, 0, 0, B, and this is equal to O matrix or null matrix. Now from this you can find equations. So what are the equations that you need? You can see, I will take this 8 plus 8 minus 2a, 8 minus 2a plus 0 is equal to 0. So from this we get 2a is equal to 4. Okay, here it is plus 8 plus 2a is equal to 4, 2a is equal to minus 8, a is equal to minus 4. Now like that we can take another one. Here you take this 3 plus A plus B is equal to 0. We know A is minus 4 plus B is equal to 0. So this gives B is equal to 1. Therefore, A is equal to minus 4, B is equal to 1. Otherwise also you can add this, that is, see 11 plus 3a plus b, one this one, and then 8 plus 2a plus 0, 8 plus 2a plus 0, that is equal to 0, 0. These two equations are there, or you can take this 4 plus a plus 0, and then 3 plus a plus b. So this is equal to, this is 0, this is 0, and this is also 0, null matrix. So from these equations we can find A and B. A is equal to minus 4, B is equal to 1. Now let me write the 17th question. 15 and 16 we will come back afterwards. Now 17th and 18th question I will write. Let A be a non-singular square matrix, A is a non-singular square matrix of order 3 cross 3, then at GA is equal to determinant of at GA.